Hello students, welcome back to the virtual lab demonstration. This video demonstrates the analysis of hematite ore. This video is for MSc part 1 students. The link for the other experiment is provided at the end of this video. To get the notification of next practical, please subscribe and like the video. I am Dr. Sujata Kasabe from ABASAHEB GARWARE College, Pune. Let us see the demonstration of practical. Aim of the experiment is determination of silica and iron in hematite. The hematite ore contains a major component of iron and small amount of silica. For the purpose of commercial application, usually the percentage of Fe2O3 in the hematite ore is reported. The ore is soluble in concentrated HCl. The insoluble residue contains silica and the filtrate contains iron. Iron is estimated volumetrically using K2Cr2O7 solution by using two different indicators. The two different indicators are K3Fe6, that is potassium ferricyanide, as an external indicator, and diphenylamine as an internal indicator. Potassium dichromate is a powerful oxidizing agent in acidic medium. It oxidizes ferrous iron to ferric iron. Initially, diphenylamine is colorless. When oxidation of Fe2+ is complete, a slight excess of K2Cr2O7 oxidizes the indicator to intense violet color. The external indicator K3Fe6 is kept outside the titration flask, that is on a porcelain tile. A drop of Fe2+ solution is withdrawn from the titration flask and mixed with a drop of the external indicator. It forms a blue colored precipitate. When all Fe2+ in the titration flask is oxidized by K2Cr2O7, the drop of the solution withdrawn from the titration flask does not form blue colored precipitate and does not show change in color with the drop of external indicator. This is the end point of the titration. Generally, for the better results, the use of internal indicator, that is diphenylamine, is preferred. Let us see the apparatus: silica crucible, gel dust flask, funnel, beaker and burette. For the analysis of hematite ore, we have to dissolve the ore. So weigh about 0.3 gram of ore on a watch glass and record this reading as W gram. Now transfer this ore in gel dust flask and then add 7 to 8 ml concentrated HCl to it. And heat the solution by allowing burner. Thereafter, remove the burner and cool the solution well, cool the flask well. And then, after cooling the flask, add to this solution 2 to 3 ml concentrated HNO3. After the addition of concentrated HNO3, again heat this solution for 2 to 3 minutes. Then again remove the burner and cool the flask well. Then add 5 ml 60% perchloric acid to the same solution. Now heat the solution again till white dense fumes start evolving. Now again remove the burner and cool the solution well. After cooling the solution, rinse the funnel by using distilled water. Add about 1 test tube distilled water. Now filter the solution through Wattman number 41 paper. Collect the filtrate in a beaker. Transfer all the silica onto the filter paper. Wash the residue with hot water till it free from chloride and acid. To check it, collect the sample in a test tube. And then test it with AgNO3 solution. To check it whether it is free from Cl or not, then test the filtrate with blue litmus paper. It should not turn to red. If it is turning to red, then wash it with hot water again. If the washings are not given properly, the final weight of the residue may increase due to adhered impurities and the filter paper may char during ignition. Now collect the filtrate and washings in the same beaker. Then transfer this solution in a 100 ml volumetric flask. And then dilute it up to the mark by using distilled water. After this, we have two parts. Part A, gravimetric estimation of silica, and part B is for volumetric estimation of iron. Now let us begin with part A, that is estimation of silica gravimetrically. For that, take the weight of empty crucible plus lead on a weighing balance. Record this as W1. For the incineration process, take weighed silica crucible and then fold the Wattman number 41 filter paper as shown in the video and ignite it till it become white, and then transfer all this filter paper in crucible. Then heat this crucible strongly on a blue flame for 2 to 3 hours. And now take the weight of this silica crucible plus lead with this residue and record this reading as a W2 gram. Observation table for part A, that is for estimation of silica gravimetrically. Weight of the empty wash glass, weight of the wash glass plus ore, weight of the ore W gram. Weight of the empty crucible plus lead, weight of the crucible plus lead plus residue, weight of the silica as X gram. Calculation: W gram ore corresponds to X gram of silica, so 100 gram ore corresponds to X into 100 divided by W is equal to Z1% of silica. Part B, that is volumetric estimation of iron. In that there are two parts. Part 1 is preparation of standard solution of 0.025 normal K2Cr2O7. To prepare the standard solution of 0.025 normal K2Cr2O7, weigh exactly K2Cr2O7 and then transfer it in a beaker. Dissolve this K2Cr2O7 in a minimum amount of distilled water and then stir it well. Transfer this K2Cr2 solution in a clean and dry 100 ml volumetric flask and then dilute it with the distilled water. Now transfer this prepared 0.025 normal K2Cr2 solution in a clean and dry beaker so as to get the homogeneous solution. So this is the part 1, that is preparation of standard solution of 0.025 normal K2Cr2O7 solution. Now part 2, that is estimation of iron. To estimate the iron, fill the burette number 2 with diluted solution of iron and then take 9 ml diluted solution of iron in a clean and dry conical flask. Add to this solution 2 ml concentrated HCl. Now boil this solution well. It becomes yellow in color due to formation of FeCl3. To this hot solution, add drop by drop 4% SnCl2 in excess to ensure complete reduction of ferric iron to ferrous iron. While adding SnCl2, remove the burner. Cool the solution in the flask thoroughly under tap water. To this cooled solution, add Drop-wise saturated solution of HgCl2 till a slight turbidity is just obtained. Avoid excess addition of HgCl2. Add to this solution 1 ml diphenylamine indicator and 2 ml phosphoric acid solution. Now titrate this solution with burette number 1 containing K2Cr2O7 solution drop by drop till the solution in the flask shows intense blue violet coloration. Record this reading as a x1 ml. This is the end point of the titration. To the same solution, add 1 ml iron solution from the burette number 2, add 2 to 3 drops of concentrated HCl and boil. To this hot solution, add carefully drop by drop SnCl2 solution till solution becomes colorless. Cool it thoroughly. Add 1 or 2 drops of HgCl2 solution till a slight turbidity is just obtained. Do not add indicator. Again, continue the titration with burette number 1 and record the reading as x2 ml. Similarly, repeat the titration for x3 ml. Observations. Given K2Cr2O7 solution, to find the exact amount of iron in the solution, burette 1 contains K2Cr2O7 solution, burette 2 contains diluted solution of iron, indicator is diphenylamine, endpoint is intense blue-violet color. Reaction is as shown over here. Observation table. Record all the readings as shown in the observation table. Calculation. 1 ml 0.025 normal K2Cr2O7 corresponds to 0.001396 gram of iron. So x1 ml 0.025 normal K2Cr2O7 corresponds to x1 into 0.001396, that is A1. Similarly, do the calculation for X2, X3 for A2, A3 respectively. Then 9 ml diluted solution contains A1 gram iron. Therefore, 100 ml diluted solution contains B1 gram of iron. Similarly, calculate for the 10 ml and for 11 ml. Take the mean of these B1, B2, B3 and record it as a B gram of iron. So, W gram ore corresponds to B gram of iron. Therefore, 100 gram ore corresponds to C percent of iron. So, 112 gram of iron corresponds to 160 gram of iron. Therefore, C gram iron corresponds to dash dash gram of Fe2O3 as D. Then finally, result table. Percentage of SiO2 in the ore. Percentage of iron in ore as C. Percentage of Fe2O3 in ore as D. And expected percentage of Fe2O3 is 85% to 90%. So, students, thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe and like the video.